Doug Flutie. And working with him, Williams, Mosley are the running backs, outstanding wide receivers. We've talked about them a little. Baker, Taylor, keep your eye on the tight end, Pflug, and the men up front who do the job, higher in the middle, Chalantzeff, Kazarian, Savage, and Willicombe. That's the offensive line. At the 29, it is first and 10. First possession of the night, midfield position. A little bit of a delay to the fullback, Mosley. He powers his way for about five, and let's set that defense for you. The ball at the 26-yard line. Williams for the first time tonight. He's got the first down as he slices his way near the 35-yard line. James Williams out of his tailback spot. Anthony Blue made the tackle. Number one. Night at the 35-yard line, we're just underway at the Silver Bowl. Still 14:30 to play in the first quarter. Ball at the 35. Sweeney will put it up for the first time tonight. Right down the middle. Baker's got it across midfield at the 48. Did he catch it? The referees say he did. Baker's first catch of the night.
So to add to the fact that there are a lot of seniors playing in the last game, what guys playing against each other who grew up together.
In and out of that. He's a good one, number 67. Walker Franklin also working up front with him. Behind him, the linebacking core. Keep your eye on Grayson and Hannemann. They'll be all over the field. Greer and Nunn also starting. Williamson, Wilburn, Webster, and Stewart. Wilburn expected to be constant company tonight for Thomas. Thomas out of the lineup right now. George Williams is in. It is second down and 10. Ball just outside the two. We're just in the first quarter. Loose football. And diving back to get it is Stedman about the one-yard line. The Rebels maintain control of the ball.
In a year from my high school, where I went to high school in Long Beach at Poly High School.
On third down, Stedman looks over the middle. Now brings it down, brings it back. It's intercepted. Picked off by Wilburn. Wilburn right there to make the interception. He almost fumbled but manages to maintain control. And the Bulldogs of Fresno State have come up with the first turnover of the night. There he is, number eight, the junior from Carson, California. Wilburn picks off the pass, and the Bulldogs are in business.
Fred Wilburn is considered to be the best defensive back on this Fresno team, a terrific athlete, number eight. He's not very big, 175 pounds, 5'10", but he's in the right spot at the right time on this play, and quite frankly, Stalwart just throws the ball. He forces the ball in there, and Fresno comes up with it on about their 31-yard line.
Mosley, the fullback inside the 20. He's got room down the sideline, cuts it back into the end zone, touchdown. The Bulldogs of Fresno State break on top. A 31-yard touchdown run by Anthony Mosley. So Mosley scores his fourth touchdown of the season, and the Dogs are howling early here in Las Vegas. Emery and Brightman are the running backs. This is Emery. Heading outside, he'll be dropped for no gain. Moving up quickly is Jethro Franklin. Jethro was not happy last week, and he is set out to make amends tonight. It's first and 10 at the 46-yard line. 8:38 to play first quarter. The Rebels are down by a touchdown. They try to go deep. Tipped away at the last minute. Going up to tip it away is Byron Nichols, number three. The intended receiver was Darnell Woods, number 81. He was open for a moment, but Nichols recovered nicely. Ball at the 40, second down, seven. Clock continues to move, 6:53. The blitz is on. Stallworth spins away. Now he's in trouble at midfield, and he's dropped. He was able to spin away one time, could not do it twice. And banged down by Anthony Nunn, number 96.
The Bulldogs put the blitz on. You can see the linebackers sneaking up there. They do a pretty good job of protection initially, but no one is open. Anthony Nunn, number 96, comes up with a big play. He gets the sack. But the quarterback, Stallworth, he had time to get the ball thrown, but actually there was no one open. You have to give credit to Fresno's defensive backs.
And for Nunn, his fifth sack of the season. It's third down and 17 now for Strip Stallworth. Again, he's under pressure, and he's dropped just by the ankle, all the way back at his own 42-yard line. That's Jethro Franklin. That's sack number 18 and a half now. On 13-yard line, first down and 10. Straight back is Sweeney. Deep down the middle looking for Baker. Can he run under it? Yes, Stephen Baker inside the 25-yard line. He put it up, and Baker ran under it.
There is no way Stephen Baker is supposed to come up with this catch. Number 25, David Hollis, is way, way back in the coverage. There's no way that Bank is supposed to get it, but he actually outruns the coverage. And in order to be able to do that, Kevin Sweeney had to throw the football a long way. There you see him striding. The ball is a little short, but he's thrown this football about 55 or 60 yards, and Baker just outruns the coverage and comes up with a tremendous effort. And that's why he's averaging about 25 yards per catch.
He got a 64 on that one at the 23-yard on a 64-yard pickup. Sweeney, 2 of 4 for 81 yards. Big numbers thus far. Comes right back the other way. That'll be interference as they tried to pick up Gene Taylor up at the 12. Penalty set him back to the 17. It's now third down. Let's see what Sweeney elects to do. Looks right. Pumps one. Throwing deep. Intended for Taylor. He's got it. Unbelievable catch by Taylor in the end zone. Touchdown, Fresno State.
Well, there's a reason why the Fresno players are all over Taylor on this play. Little hitch and go, but good coverage by number 25, David Hollis. And you can see, number one, watch the concentration. He keeps his eye on the football all the way and goes up and comes down with an incredible catch for the touchdown. Gene Taylor just makes this play entirely on his own.
They've had some pretty good receivers at Fresno State. How about Henry Ellard and Stephone Paige? We're seeing a couple more tonight, right, Gene?
You certainly are. Stephone Paige with Kansas City and, of course, Henry Ellard with the Rams. And the people at Fresno say this pair of Baker and Taylor are just as good as those receivers, and that's saying a mouthful.
The kickoff from Belli will come deep to Thomas and Emery. Thomas is the man they want to get it. He backpedals into the end zone. Is he coming out?
He comes out, he goes back in. Do that.
The official rules. Safety.
We got it.
He came out, he went back in, he downed the ball. You were right, Gene, you can't do that.
Well, I know you can't do that because once in my career at Stanford, they put me back there. I came out and my partner back there said, go down, and I went down on about the 1 yard line. So I've seen this mistake before. Can't go out, come back, and I think he was realizing, did I make a mistake? And you certainly did, George Thomas. It's abandoned.
Minute 38 left, first quarter. Third down, a couple. Brightman will not get the first down, no gain. Brightman quickly wrapped up. Mark Olson, who was hurt last week in the game against Cal State Fullerton. Olson, not expected to start tonight, but he's out on the field and he makes a big, big defensive play there.
Double cover George Thomas. Do not let him get the football.
A busted play for the Rebels on third and long. Walker, number 90, right in the middle of things to mess it up for Strip Stallworth.
Yes, it's true.
I think every father should get the opportunity to be on the sideline with his son. I've had Father's Day most often throughout 36 years of coaching on the high school and college level. I think it's a privilege to be on the football team with your son, and I feel strongly, as other coaches in America do, that I'm an extension of the parents' arm anyway, so every football coach is worth much thanks if every football player has a son.
The father and son tandem from Fresno. Sweeney and Sweeney, Jim and Kevin.
5'6", 181. He's pretty well put together. Tough player.
He only got about a half yard. There's play action. Sweeney looks down over the middle. He has his man. Upended. Blue made the tackle. Now that's a tight end, number 41, and we don't have a 41. So unless Dugan or Pflug has changed jerseys, I'm not sure who that is. Pflug has changed jerseys, so he's wearing 41 now instead of 17, and he was wide open down the middle.
Sweeney does a good job of finding him underneath the coverage. He wanted to go downfield. No one opened there, and he had to come to Paul Pflug. Watch the offense from Alvin Horn's perspective. See how the free safety sees it.
Sweeney, pass complete. Taylor has it. Gets away from one man. He's down at the 15-yard line. Teddy Nelson, number 39, on top of him, but Gene Taylor made the catch. Good yardage, another first down for Fresno State. 17 of 25 in field goals coming in. He has 2 points tonight. He holds the career record for points, 237, looking for 240. Looks good from here. And it is. The field goal comes with a minute 9 left in the first half and stretches the lead to 19-0.
I would imagine that he would play in the second half. They're not out of the football game yet.
Straight drop. Again, he throws short. Boy, there's a hit. Incomplete pass, it's called. That was Michael Stewart, number five, that just came up and crunched Darren Brightman. Darren could not hang on to the football. So with 48 seconds remaining, it'll be second down.
Michael Stewart, number five, is in a position as we watch the coverage where he can sit back and wait for the ball to be thrown underneath. Then he comes up and delivers a blow. And that's what you call a good fundamental football position.
And with just over a minute to play here in the second quarter, the field goal by Belli, and it's 19-0. Going deep and overthrown, intercepted. That's Greg Williamson, number 28. Williamson will be run out of bounds with 3 seconds on the clock. He aired it out, and Williamson just played it deep and made the interception. There's a good reason for it. Second down, about three. The fullback is stacked up. Icky Woods had the ball.
Number 90, Mike Walker. He has done an exceptional job playing in this ball game, plays on the nose and outside, playing for an injured Mark Olson. Although Mark Olson has played some of the time, he's still suffering from a sprained ankle. Coach Kevin Sweeney on the sideline and watching his charges. There's number 90, Mike Walker.
Running backs are split behind Stallworth. Third, a yard and a half, straight ahead, power running by Woods. He will not get to the first down. He stopped a yard short. Mark Olson, number 59, who's kind of played in spots tonight, and a flag goes down.
Number 96, though, Anthony Nunn, he really stood up the line of scrimmage. He just stopped it right there. Take a look. Number 96, right in the middle of the screen, comes in there. He stands it up. No place to go for Darren Brightman, effectively.
Now it's third down. Straight back, Stallworth. Looks up the middle, has time, flags down all over the place. Stallworth is dropped at the 20-yard line. Getting up is Cliff Hannemann, who was all over him. Got some help from Greg Ramsey, number 87. So 77 and 87 team up that time, but we've got holding. I would assume they will decline it since they've got the ball back at the 20 and it's 4th and 16.
Holding on the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Watch number 67 in the middle of your screen, and that's Jethro Franklin. He's being held by Oprin in the middle. The officials catch it as number 77, Cliff Hannemann, comes in and puts a stop on Stallworth.
There's Bob Holberg. This is his fifth punt, averaging just over 35. At midfield is Stephen Baker. Nice kick. Backing Baker up to the 39-yard line. He's got some room on the far side. A lot of room as he goes down the sideline. One man to beat. He can't do it. Baker, though, puts the ball out of the flag down at the 14-yard line. A great return by Baker. Boy, they had the wall set up, Gene.
And there's a clip. There's a clip on about the 14-yard line. The thing that really make this play work, though, was that Baker, in a situation where you might think he would fair catch, gets the ball on the run, gets to the outside, and there's the picket fence. It's set up, but you'll see the clip on number 21. Right there's a clip. A little push from behind. The official is right on the spot, picks it up, and they'll bring it back.
That will knock off part of that 48-yard return of the punt by Baker, and there you see it. He's trying to get some help out in front from Michael Stewart.
During the run back, first down.
For the Bulldogs. Quick pop by Williams straight ahead. He'll be short of the first down, lost the football. The Rebels think they have it, and they do. Knight came up with it. Marion Knight, number 54. And the Rebels get another turnover, their second one in the third quarter.
This is exactly what they wanted to do, was to keep the momentum on their side. There is the fumble. You can see the ball was loose before Williams went down. The Rebels have come up with a football. And again, this third quarter, as it did last week, belongs to the Rebels.
Passing situation, third and nine. Bowen, straight drop. He's under the gun. And they've got him. Inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Hannemann was there. The initial surge went by Bowen, but filling in from behind Grayson and Hannemann pick up the sack.
Out the clock here is trying to keep this lead they have and not lose the ball game as opposed to continue with what they had in winning it.
Skipper gets it across the 35, across the 40. He's got a first down at the 43-yard line. A little shovel pass to Kelly Skipper.
Up to 22-7. And that puts them more than two touchdowns ahead of the Rebels.
Kelly Skipper with some room. Dancing away inside the 20. Inside the 15 to the 14-yard line before Hollis made the tackle. But good running that time by the sophomore from Eugene, Oregon.
Well, but maybe this is the angle that they want their kicker Belli to kick from.
It'll be a 28-yard field goal attempt, and you can look on with us. It looks good. Is it long enough? Yes, it is. So Belli is true from 28 yards out. It is 22-7, a 15-point lead for Fresno with the field goal attempt. It's blocked and picked up. Running out of bounds on the play. It's Rod Webster, number 19. He picked it up after it was blocked and headed for the sidelines. It appeared that Byron Nichols got a piece of the ball. They really smothered the play. Webster's the one that picked it up and ran it out of bounds, but 3:20 remaining in the game. The Bulldogs starting to breathe a little bit easier now. They've got the football back, and they've still got a 15-point lead. 22-7, Fresno State. Trying to stay alive in that PCAA race. Good running by Skipper. He's still on his feet. He can score. Skipper at the 10. It's a foot race now. He'll take it down and in for the touchdown.
Number 26, Kelly Skipper.
A great run by Kelly Skipper. Looked like he was going to get about 5 yards. He took it all the way for the touchdown. A 42-yard touchdown run.
We talked earlier about how strong Skipper is in spite of the fact that he stands only 5'6". But in that 5 feet 6 inches is 180 pounds, and most of it is in his legs. You get an idea of how strong he is from the waist down. Breaks 3 or 4 tackles and goes in for 6 points. Terrific job of running by Kelly Skipper. Have to be more reminiscent of the game last season.
And the final minute and 15 seconds for 17 seniors here for the Rebels of UNLV. The sack. Bowen is dropped by Rod Webster. Webster coming up from the defensive secondary, sneaking around the outside and sacked him back at the 10-yard line. So it is the end of the road here at the Silver Bowl. That is Bustamante, I'm sorry. Bustamante made the sack back at the 10. They're going to kick it away. Clock winding down with 48 seconds to play. And so the senior season ends for a lot of outstanding athletes here at UNLV. They have a couple more games remaining, but they will play those games on the road away from the Silver Bowl. They will play at New Mexico State next week and on to Hawaii. For Fresno State, Baker back in there to take the kick. Got some room down the right side. If he can sneak through, he does. He's got room down the sideline, inside the 40. He could go all the way. He's got a convoy. Stephen Baker for the touchdown.
And if the penalty flag is against the Rebels, it'll be 6 points. But yet, that remains to be seen. There's a flag on the field. We'll have to wait to see who the call is against.
Illegal procedure goes against the defense. It'll be a 66-yard touchdown return. It comes in the closing seconds, and Stephen Baker, the touchdown maker, did just that.
Baker nearly got away with one earlier. Heads up, field draws the people to the inside, and you see the picket line, the wall forms to the right as Baker breaks a couple of arm tackles, and now it's all over but the shouting as he just stretches it out and eases into the end zone. Another 6 points, but of course it was academic at that point.
66 yards he goes for the touchdown, the extra point. You try to push it to 36-7. You look back in the years to come at this one and you say, piece of cake for Fresno State. That wasn't exactly the case.